Well, I'm running for mayor in 2038.
Oh, you've got a plan?
2038.
Every hour is happy hour. Thank you for your vote.
You're listening to What a Joke.
With Tom Papa and Fortune Theme Song.
On Netflix is a joke radio.
Sirius XM Channel 93.
The very talented Ross Mathews is here with us.
Ross,
nice to see you. You look great.
Thank you so much. I'm really so excited to be here.
It's so nice to have someone with energy. Usually people are rolling in here. Comedians are all cranky and it's so early, but you've been up for hours.
Yeah, I'm a morning person, you know, an early riser.
It's so nice.
I was telling you, during the break, you know, I wake up early because my chihuahuas, I have three of them, are like, they nudge me. So about five every morning I'm up, and then I'm just a perky person.
That's great. He said he walks his dogs through the neighborhood like Belle.
In Beauty and the Beast. Good day, Bonjour. I know my neighbors.
Do you live alone? I'm wondering. I'm trying to set the scene of these dogs.
I just said three chihuahuas. I'm single. You know, I was in a relationship for like 10 years.
Oh, really?
And so for like a year now, I've been single.
Oh.
So I am sort of alone. Yeah.
I don't mean lonely. I mean,
I'm not lonely.
I'm just picturing the scene of the dogs. Like, why are you the one getting up and having to go outside?
Well, because the parade of homosexual men that go through my house don't know to get up with the dogs. They don't know the routine.
That parade.
The one night. You thought that was fun.
Everyone picturing it.
All those homosexual men.
You thought you had fun. Now you have to walk the dogs.
Good morning.
Ross already discovered his juicy fruit.
Yeah,
that's a treat for you.
Is it for a fruit? Do you give this to every fruit that walks
everybody,
in?
Oh, you thought it was a gay joke.
I just assumed. Chew on that. Do you live together now, almost?
Yeah,
almost to that point.
Almost. We're thinking about getting an apartment in New York together.
What you should do is go in on a place in Palm Springs.
That's right.
So you can be near me.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is that where you live?
Well, I live here in Burbank, and then I live in Palm Springs as well.
Oh, how He's often like, are you in Palm Springs?
All the time.
Really?
He's the unofficial mayor.
Well, I'm running for mayor in 2038.
Oh, you've got a plan?
2038?
Yeah. Every hour is happy hour. Thank you for your vote.
Yeah.
I have a platform.
You would be a great Palm Springs mayor.
Yeah.
You know, I would show up to the ceremonies.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly. The fun events, mm-hmm. but like the city planning. You'd be like,
do you know how many parades you would have?
So many.
Yeah. Oh my God. Just so I could wave.
Yeah. I'm starting to become a fan of Palm Springs myself.
I love Palm Springs. Mm-hmm. I love that heat.
It's lesbians are starting to move there.
Yeah, I know, but it's still great. No, you know I love that.
I know.
Well, we welcome everybody.
We welcome everybody. Everybody. That's the motto. We welcome everybody, even the lesbians.
What would you rather have as a neighbor, a straight couple or a lesbian couple?
Oh, well,
that's a tough one.
Could I see a headshot? No, I'd have probably, I mean, listen, I love all people. I'd love if Fortune were to move next door to me. That would
of
be
course.
The gold mine.
For
of
course.
The barbecues alone.
Oh.
I just picture like just constant roast pork coming from your backyard.
That sounds beautiful. God,
that would be nice.
Yeah.
We're not your typical lesbians. I don't know how to golf. I don't know how to fix anything.
Uh-huh.
I don't even know how to barbecue. Your thing that you envision sounds amazing.
You sound like a gay man, just so you know.
I am, on the inside, a gay man. Mm-hmm. I look like a lesbian, obviously.
Well,
but
we have the same thing. On the inside, I'm a gay man, and I look like a lesbian.
Yeah.
And sound like one, too.
No, I'm very gay man on the inside.
Uh-huh.
I love a brunch, love a happy hour. I love some hot goss. I watch Bravo.
Yeah. Okay. So you're gonna fit in fine in Palm Springs. You should come hang out with us.
I would. I like it out there. Yeah. I really like it out there.
Would you? Are you gonna? You're talking. How many kids do you have?
Two
kids. Fortune. Yeah. Are you gonna do that?
We're on the fence. We don't know.
On the fence.
Jax would be such a good mom.
Yes.
I don't know.
You'd be a good dad.
I want to do it like Diane Keaton and Baby Boom. You know, where like a baby, like a distant relative just gives you one and you're like, baby.
Jax feels like that's going to happen to us.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Like someone's just going to tell us in a couple of years that they need us to watch, like care for a child.
Right.
I was like, does that happen? But I don't know. She just feels like someone's going to be like, we need you guys to parent this child.
Well, my friend just went through a divorce, and now she's being a real whore. And she had a pregnancy scare because she had sex in an alley with someone she didn't know.
Wait, what?
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Oh, my
gosh. I've never been more thrilled in my life. I thought, oh, it's coming true. This is, you're going to have the baby, and I'm going to raise it. And then, so I've
got, do you want a baby?
Oh, my God, so bad.
Really? You do? I didn't know that.
Yeah, always.
So many gay men are having babies. Yeah. Lately,
you know, it's the 90s. But I just always pictured myself being a dad. I knew I'd have kids by the time I was 35.
Right.
And now I just turned 40. So I don't know that that happened.
Right.
Yeah. So
so you got to make it happen soon, though, because you're going to get tired.
Well, I am tired already. But I would just hire someone to, like, raise right. it. And then I would, you know, Christmas, I'd be like Joan Crawford.
Right, do the picture.
Christina, which is your favorite gift? And that's the one you keep. I would be a great dad. But I don't know. I felt like I always would do it. And then time is ticking.
And then you were in a 10-year relationship.
And then we didn't. And now I'm, you know, single and sort of feel like I got to lock that down. I got to figure out what my home base is.
Because you would like to have a partner to do this with.
Or yeah.
You would.
You like relationships?
I do. I'm a relationship person.
Yeah.
But dating is really, it's an interesting new thing. I never did, you know, I was kind of single. I've been on TV since I'm 21.
Yeah.
And then I was just kind of like a clown. I never feel, you know, I felt like worthy of it. So I didn't really date until I met my partner forever when I was 28. Uh-huh. And then we were together till I was like 38, 39.
Yeah.
And so now I find myself as a grown up dating for the first time. It's really interesting.
Yeah.
What do you mean you didn't feel worthy of it?
You know,
Being on television?
No, I didn't. I felt
of a relationship.
Love.
Of love. You know, it was almost so overwhelming. I was in college when I got on The Tonight Show. I mean, really in the dorms. And then it went from like having this dream to then people knowing who I was and being out there. And then I was sort of like, I was very excited on that show, you know, and then that sort of became, because I was excited.
You were so great. You
Thank
were such,
you.
I mean, you just popped off the screen. It was just such a dynamic part of that show.
It was crazy.
How did you get it? What do you mean you were in the dorms?
I was an intern. I was working there for free.
Oh.
And then they thought I was, but I always wanted to interview celebrities. I always wanted to be on TV.
Right.
And one day they just thought, they were like, oh, you know, a comic dropped out of covering Ocean's 11 premiere. That's how long ago it was, 2001.
Right.
And they said, you know, who's funny is Ross in the hall. And so they sent me out and they thought it was like a gimmick. And in my head, I was like, oh, this is the beginning of my career.
This is my moment.
Yeah.
So
and
so, great.
And then the ratings were just great. And
yeah.
Then, so they asked me to do another one. I did that show for 14 years.
Oh,
14 years?
That long?
Wow.
It was, yeah. I did it till Jay left. We went to, it was the Tonight Show and then Jay Leno Show and then back to the Tonight Show and all of it. And
wow, 14 years.
Yeah.
Well, that makes sense. It did have a real impact.
But in that time, it was this, you know, in your 20s, I'm figuring out how to pay the gas, but I don't know.
Right.
Meanwhile, I'm like on TV. Dating to me is I just sort of felt like, oh, people look at me to laugh. So, they're not looking to me for sex or
right.
So I just kind of thought, oh, that's not a part of your life, you know?
And no, that's weird.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah, that is weird. Because it seems like, you know, if you had this natural thing that you want to be in relationships and stuff, but I guess fame is kind of a little bit of a head thing.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't do like the, you know, coke and like party thing.
Right.
I just did the sort of like put head down and work thing.
Oh. Right, right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you ever feel like doing a version of that in a new way, like having it your own show of dealing with celebrities and stuff like that? You have that down so well.
Yes. I mean, we did Chelsea Lately together, Fortune and I, and then I had a show on E sort of interviewing people.
Right.
And so I think about it. What I want to do next, you know what I really want to do next?
I'd love to know.
It's all about me right now.
It is.
But, it is.
Well, I want to do a game show. That's what I want to do. I want to do giveaways. I love the energy of prices.
Right.
Good at that.
Yeah.
Just sort of good. I think people look to me to sort of like, I just smile for a second.
Yeah,
you
bring
know?
The joy.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so I want to do a game show.
That would be good. With celebrities or regular people?
I mean, who's ever hiring? You know?
Yeah.
I got to figure it out. If I could in a perfect world, would be The Price is Right. That's the gig to get because you could do it for 30 years.
Right.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Right?
I know.
Or Let's Make a Deal. Can Wayne Brady just...
He doesn't seem like he's enjoying it anyway.
Just ask Drew Carey
he
if
doesn't.
He's ready to retire.
One of them. Can we just start a tweet campaign to get one of them to retire?
Yeah, you would be better than both of them.
Stop.
I like them both.
I like them both.
But you're more
You're a happy guy. Yeah. You want to give prizes away.
Yeah, you fit that. Thank you. Would be great.
And and women love running to you.
They do. Come on down. That's the goal.